Hey, I'm Oliver Phelps.
I'm James Phelps, and we're going to show you the tour of the kitchen here on the set of Harry Potter Wizards of Baking. Come with us.
Come and have a look. Right now, as kitchens go, I have determined that this is the type of kitchen you don't want your wife to see, because it'll be, oh, we need this, we need this, we need this when we get home.
He's talking from experience.
Yes, definitely. But let me show you what I think we need in every house. Chocolate on tap.
Chocolate tempering is a very important part of what a lot of the bakers are doing here, so it needs to be kept at a perfect temperature, which is what this is doing right now.
Currently coming to you at 45 degrees centigrade.
What's that in old money?
I don't know. Hot. But all I do know is it is yummy. But we've not just got dark chocolate, we've got white chocolate over here as well. And as James said, it's a big part of the show, so the bakers can just literally come here with a big bowl. None of this trying to melt a load on the stove for about half an hour, then burning your stove from experience again.
And we're here with Martin as well, who is the
chocolate magician, we're going to call him right now.
Martin, what do all these machines do?
Basically, it's tempering the chocolate. So chocolate's quite complicated. It needs to go up to melt it to a temperature, and then we need to lower it to 27, 28.
Okay.
And then hold it at 31 degrees, right. And the machines will do the work for us.
Right, and does that make it set pretty quickly?
Yeah, so that you get that nice crisp snap, nice shine on the chocolate. If you don't do that, the fat will start to come to the surface.
Yes, excellent, right.
Thanks, yeah. Good to know,
awesome.
Thank you. And because obviously we're in Hogwarts-esque territory, looking over everybody, there's certain homages to the movies and the series, so you've got the sorting hat there. Good old scene, especially from the eating scenes in the movies. Huge fridges.
What's in the fridge?
Go and have a look.
This is a freezer.
Oh, yes.
So inside here, we've got some pastry stuff. We've got some sponge from the different contestants. I'm going to shut it in case it goes wrong and I'm in trouble.
Another thing that we have as well is a printer which prints edible rice paper. So some bakes, so you've got letters from Hogwarts there, so this is what it's made of.
I'm just, don't give it away.
Taster.
Got to watch the show. But also as well, as we said, it's all about keeping temperature right as well. So we've got sugar temperatures at the bottom here as well. See these little chrome things here. Then up here as well, we've got a vacuum machine as well, so they can actually use it to affect their bakes, because there's different elements that come into it. This isn't just a load of fairy cakes or a few cupcakes. These are amazing showpieces. And they've got all these to choose from as well, just to add to it. But that's not all. Let's get to that side of the kitchen.
So this is a dough sheeter. Think if you're ever making pasta, but for dough. So you can do all things for croissants, anything like that. It all goes through here.
You want to be careful how you say that, don't you?
No.
Dough sheeter.
And over this side, we've got a freezer, you know. Everyone's got a freezer, right?
It's a good freezer, but this is the mega freezer, a speed freezer.
You know when you're really hot, say you're in the Midwest at the moment, it's very warm, not in here. See, it's that cold, it's stuck.
Look at the amount of crew we've got here, the amount of cameramen, everyone like that. They're all getting ready for starting this show. And now we're gonna show you the baking stations, the kitchen tables, the drawers filled with everything. And we did actually hear from some of the chefs earlier, the best thing about coming in here, brand new equipment.
Everything is brand spanking new, very shiny, as you can see. Every utensil you would need to be a wizard of baking. And this is one of my favorite parts, they're very posh as well. Look at these doors, look, they go in. You're not gonna knock your legs when you're running past.
Well, could you imagine, right? You got a brand new bake, you're gonna go bang, all on the floor.
Well, come on, but just look how many utensils are. So come. Put those in. So you've literally got every ruler, you've got literally every kind of utensil that you need here.
What does that one do?
That measures things.
No, that one. So this fish spatula delicately picks things up.
Hang on. The whole kitchen, you've gone for a fish spatula.
You never know.
This is wasted on you.
You never know.
Go away.
You're the one who's looking at a drawer. Right, another good thing as well. Come and have a look at this induction hob. Again, we've already spoken about regulating temperature so everything's worked properly. So the good thing about these induction hobs is that when you've got the saucepan on top and it's cooking, unlike using gas where it can just predominantly heat the sides, this heats the whole center. You can tell I've been listening to the chefs.
They were very excited about that, weren't they?
They were.
There's power outlets under here as well. So literally, and it's about 15 foot, give or take, this whole station. So the guys have a lot of space to work. They're working in pairs as well, so they're not getting in each other's way. Paper at this at the top of the table for their designs, just to make sure what they're making is right.
Double ovens, which is heating up right now. We best not do that because you don't want to change the regulation of the temperature. Again, some more freezers and fridges.
And all the sheets. And all the trays that they'll need, all the bacon, and they're all listed as well, so they can work very quickly in what they need. And that's not all. The teams have just designed what they need to make. So they'll come, literally stick it up on the wall here so they know what to refer to as they're going. Then they've got 8 hours to make amazing bakes. Other different things as well. Stairs. We're very fortunate in terms of leaning over because we're quite tall.
Like this.
But some guys need a bit of a boost, so that's there as well. Literally everything has been thought about.
But we were talking about what's in these fancy compartments earlier. We also have, for all the contestants, edible elements that they can obviously put onto their bakes to make it taste nicely. What have we got here? We've got, let's just get the whole lot out here. Got different colorings as well, obviously. Orange, bit of gold, bit of violet.
All the pans that you'd ever need to make absolutely anything in here. Trays, dishes, everything. And because this is very health and safety as well, fire blankets. Every kitchen should have one of these in.
All right, fun police. Right, we're gonna move on now because we have got where the contestants come in to the kitchen. And obviously, being in the wizarding world, they're gonna come through one way or the other. Best way, flue powder network. So come over here. Quite fitting that in the kitchen, we've got the portrait of the fat lady overlooking everything, all the yummy food.
So we're gonna take the flue powder now to go on to some of the other Harry Potter sets where we shoot the show. So we'll see you there.
Cheerio.